The escalating cost of learning means students are returning to school hungry and without the very basics. A KidsCan survey this morning finds 65% of schools say poverty is worsening in their communities, with 47 schools reporting students who had taken on part-time jobs or left school altogether to work. John Topp is the Deputy Principal of Porirua College and he joins us now. Morena, John, thank you so much for being with us this morning. I mean, you know this. I mean, you know, you may not particularly have the stats, but you know this because your school is experiencing it as well. So talk to us about those experiences.
Morena, Jenny May. Yes, we do have those experiences at Porirua College. We have students coming to school without uniform, without devices, without lunch. They come to school hungry because they haven't had breakfast that morning. We see that every day.
And how does that make your students feel? Because, you know, it's tough enough sometimes turning up at school, but when you're hungry or you don't have the right uniform, it has an impact on students, right?
It does, and they feel a bit whack-a-mole about that. So what we do is we provide them with both a breakfast and a lunch, and we also give them some uniform and any of the equipment they might need for school. That includes sporting equipment if they need that as well.
Now, I know that it's probably tough being part of that leadership group that is seeing your family struggle on a day-to-day basis, but it's also tough for the parents to expose their personal situations as well. So how do you have those conversations with parents?
You take time to build a relationship with them, and once you build a relationship with them, they end up trusting you, and it ends up that we've both got the same goal in mind, and that's doing the best and having the best for the tamariki. So it just takes time to build that trust, and once that trust is there, they're able to say, look, we need some help, and we're able to say, this is the help that we can give.
John, obviously this is an issue for this year, but this isn't a new problem for your school, right?
This is not a new problem. It's been going on for years, even before COVID, which COVID's just made it worse, but it has been ongoing for years. And building a relationship with people like and organisations like KidsCan has allowed us to get some of the resources that we need to support our tamariki and their whānau at times so that they can get their children to school.
Yeah, so you talk about KidsCan. There's also Ka Ora Ka Ako, which is the Healthy Schools Lunch Program. How important are those programs for your students?
Well, if you're coming to school hungry and you know that you've got food at school, you're going to come to school. It just happens. So they're really important. Once they've come to school and had their lunch, then they're learning better in the classroom and having better relationships with each other and with the staff. So without those programs, both KidsCan and the Healthy School Lunches, life would be a lot more difficult for us at PC.
What support do you need? What further support is required?
Well, that's a very good question. I mean, depends on how big the purse is. But the staff need both training and time to work with our tamariki and their whānau. It would be great to have more support for devices and for uniform, because those devices and uniform come out of the school budget. The Healthy School Lunches is fantastic, KidsCan are fantastic, and we just need people to understand that the young people at school, if we don't make a difference for them now, they're just going to follow the same path as many other people before them have followed and end up unhealthy, in lower paying jobs, without retirement savings, not owning a home. We need to break the cycle.
Yeah. John, I just want to wrap this conversation up. You've given some great examples on what needs to happen, and I think about lunches in schools and the potential for that not to continue. So in terms of the new government, is there anything that you'd like to see from them when it comes to kids in schools?
Yeah, well, for the new government, it's easy to blame the parents for not providing food for and equipment and uniform for the young people. That's true, but if we don't provide them for them, we're punishing the students, the young people, the tamariki, for what's happening to them at home. So, yeah, we want to continue with the school lunches.
Yeah, John Topp, Porirua College Deputy Principal, joining us this morning. Really appreciate your time this morning, John, and go well this for this year with your students and the school. Thank you.
You're welcome.